Hello everyone. Today we'll be discussing about some basic concepts of wave. First, let us see what is a wave. A spread or disturbance created in any medium is known as wave. As we know, wave transfers energy from one location to another location. So basically what happens is, when a wave is formed, the molecule starts vibrating. And these vibrations are transferred to its neighboring molecule. And the neighboring molecule also starts vibrating. And from the neighboring molecule, it is transferred to the another molecule. And so on, the energy is passing from one molecule to another molecule. So in this whole concept, we can understand that wave transfers energy from one location to another location, but there is no actual bodily movement of particles. So particles do not move from one location to another location, but only wave transfers its energy from one location to another location. So in this animation, we can see that the bird is vibrating in its mean position, or the position of the bird is not changing. But you can see that the waves are moving. From this we can understand that waves only transfer energy from one location to another location. Types of waves. There are basically two types of waves. First one is a mechanical wave. Second one, electromagnetic wave. So mechanical waves always require material medium for their propagation. This means mechanical waves cannot propagate through vacuum, or mechanical waves cannot move through vacuum. So they always require some material medium for their propagation. So some of the good examples are, for example, water is a medium for water waves. Similarly, air is a medium for sound waves. So this is the reason for why we can't hear sound in vacuum, because sound always require material medium for its propagation. So hence these kind of waves cannot propagate through vacuum. So another kind is electromagnetic wave. So electromagnetic waves do not require any medium for propagation. They even can propagate through vacuum. So one of the best example is the light waves. So light waves do not require any material medium for their propagation. They even can pass in vacuum. There are three types of mechanical waves. They are transverse waves, longitudinal waves, and surface waves. In our discussion, we'll be discussing about transverse wave and longitudinal waves. Transverse wave. So motion in which all points on a wave oscillate along paths at right angles to the direction of waves at once. Now what do you mean by this? So if wave is propagating in one direction, its particles will be vibrating exactly in right angles to the propagation of wave. Once again, if wave is propagating in one direction, then the particles will be vibrating at right angles to the direction of propagation. So it is very well understood from this animation. So here, the red dotted particles indicate the vibration of the particles, and you can see the propagation of wave, right? So the wave is propagating in one direction, and the red color box, you can see that it is exactly moving right angles to the propagation of wave. So this is called as a transverse wave. In a longitudinal wave, the particles are displaced parallel to the direction the wave travels. So here, a very best example is, example of longitudinal wave is a compressions moving along a slinky. So this is a toy which we might have used. It is just like a spring, right? So if you hold that slinky and if you just pull that slinky from one side, you can observe that the motions are exactly propagating horizontal to the direction of wave. So here we can find that we can make a horizontal longitudinal wave by just pushing or pulling the slinky. So you can very well understand from this animation. So just by pushing the slinky slightly, you can find the transfer of energy in the form of longitudinal waves, right? So the compressions are exactly transferred in the direction which is parallel to the direction of wave motion. So what we can understand from this? In a longitudinal wave, the particles are displaced parallel to the direction the wave travels. So an example is very well depicted in this animation. Just by pulling or pushing the slinky, we can find that the compressions are traveling in a horizontal motion. So quickly we can just list out the differences between transverse wave and longitudinal wave. So one of the basic differences is that in the previous animation you might note that clearly that in transverse wave the motion of particles is exactly in right angles to the propagation of wave. But if you compare the same thing with the longitudinal wave, what is the difference that you can note? The difference is that the energy or the compressions of the longitudinal wave are traveling exactly in the same direction as that of the propagation of the wave. So this is about today's discussion. Thank you.